Hello, hello, hello. Today is May 4, 2023. It's about 7 o'clock in the morning for me. I'm recording now the solutions to problem 170, but I'm not going to post it today. That will come maybe 3 days from now, maybe 4, I don't know. So, I have selected the solution from Ulf Heller, but I have adjusted it. And you will see shortly why I have adjusted it. Let's first look at the problem the way I had it. Look at this drawing. If you can see it, it's not very sharp, not very clear, but that is the problem. So we had a disk. This is the disk. And the disk is rolling, pure roll. I call this angle here at the top phi, and I call, this is my yx axis, and this is x0 and y0. And the question now is, what is vx and what is vy? When the angle phi is 180 degrees. In other words, when P is here at the bottom, P is in contact with the surface. So what I'm basically saying, at any point in time, what is the velocity of this point here, the point of contact in the x and in the y direction? And this is my yx coordinate system. First, the short solution. Vy must be zero at point of contact, otherwise the disk would not be in contact with the floor. So that's easy. Let's now discuss vx. We have pure roll. That means the center of mass, so that is the center of the disk, has a speed v of omega r, and that v is in the plus x direction. That's the condition of no slip, pure roll. That means all points of the disk must move with that speed in the x direction. But all points on the outer surface of the disk also move with a clockwise tangential velocity, omega r. That's regardless whether there is slip or no slip. In other words, at the point of contact, where phi is 180 degrees, the tangential speed is in the minus x direction, but the velocity of the center of mass is in the positive direction. In other words, Vx is omega r minus omega r, which is zero. So that's the short solution. Let's now go to Ulf Heller. I first have to say that he chooses a different coordinate system from mine. There is nothing wrong with that, since we are only dealing with velocities. You can choose your coordinate system any way you want to. That will not affect velocities. So he chooses x is 0 and y is 0 right here at the center, whereas I chose it here, remember? So he chooses it here, nothing wrong with it. He calls this angle capital phi. And so now news is when x is 0, then r, x is 0, x is 0 is here, then y is r, and phi is 0. So make phi 0, then you are here at the top, then x is 0, but y is r. If phi is 180 degrees, that means it's here, then x is again 0, but y is now minus r in his system. And he mentioned that here. Phi is 0, x is 0, y is plus r. Then phi is pi over 2, then x is r and y is 0. And when phi is pi, x is 0 and y is minus r. So that's his coordinate system. In that coordinate system, x is r sine phi and y is r cosine phi. So now he takes the derivative, dx dt and dy dt. This is dx dt and this is dy dt. That's trivial high school physics. Phi dot is d phi dt is omega. And this, of course, is the velocity in the x direction, and this is the velocity in the y direction. V is omega r, only in the positive x direction. So the total V must be the velocity of the center of mass, which in the x direction is this V, plus the one that is due to the rotation. That's this one. And so Vx is this x dot plus omega r. And Vy is this y dot, but there is no motion in the y direction of the center of mass, so that is plus zero. So he finds then that Vx is this, Vy is this. You substitute in there that cosine phi is minus 1 when phi is 180 degrees, and you find immediately that Vx is 0. And Vy is also 0 because the sine of phi is 0. So that's Ulf Heller's solution, perfectly fine. He adds, which is very nice, the trajectory is a cycloid. And the cycloid can be described by a parametric expression. And this is the x in the cycloid, and this is the y in the cycloid. He does not mention that he now changes again the coordinate system. In other words, his angle phi here is now this angle here. And when phi is 0, when this angle is 0, then x is 0. But y is also 0. So he now chooses this point here to be x is 0 and y is 0, and he chooses this angle phi as the angle phi. So now he applies this part, which is the x part of the cycloid. Phi is 0, x is 0, phi is pi, then x is pi times r, because The rolling object has moved in a horizontal direction over a distance pi r. If the angle phi is 2 pi, then in the horizontal direction the disk has moved 2 pi r. That's the whole idea of pure roll. And so in the y direction, when phi is 0, y is 0, and when pi is 5, y is 2r. This point here is then 2r, because this is y is 0, so this is y is 2r. So that is a very good coordinate system for the cycloid, and here you see then the cycloid. This is the x direction, and this is the y direction. So anywhere here, I call that the floor, y is 0. And then you see this beautiful cycloid. So I think his solution is very nice. The fact that he changes twice coordinate system, I'm sure he was aware of it, but I thought I will spend some time on that so that you appreciate it. All right, as I said, I will not post this solution right away. I will wait a few more days. Most of you have difficulties with this problem. I would say about 50% of you have it right. So I shouldn't say most of you. About 50% have it right and about 50% have it wrong. But we still have a few days before I post it, so that may change. If this is too difficult for you, don't feel bad. Just look at my solutions and then you learn some physics, if that's what you want to. I would like to add something about the cycloid. It would be nice if I could make you see a cycloid. If you took a disk and you would manage to get a one point on the circumference, a light, say a red light, and you put that disk on the table and you roll it on the table and you videotape that, and then you look at your video, you would see a cycloid. I could not do that, but I could do something a little bit similar. I could take a disk which I rotate about an axis, and the axis stands still. So the disk simply rotates about an axis with a light at its circumference. So the light goes around like this. I take my video camera and I move my video camera like this. And I look at the video, I will see something very similar to a cycloid. Trust me, I tried it, but I failed bitterly. If some of you succeed, I would love to see your cycloid. I really would.